डिस्कशन करेंगे. तो नाउ द सेकंड पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इन इंग्लिश एंड आई वेलकम ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स एंड पीपल हु आर वाचिंग अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. वी हैव अ वेरी स्पेशल टॉपिक टुडे, लव इन क्रिश्चियनिटी एंड इस्लाम. एंड वंस अगेन आई हैव डॉक्टर नईम मुश्ताक विद मी. डॉक्टर साहब वंस अगेन वेलकम. And this time we are going to do English. And first, the question for you: why you thought of this topic, and what is special about this topic in your mind?
Well, when I used to talk to Christian missionaries friends in Pakistan, they used to, in theological discussions and debates with them, they used to come up with a topic like, "We are the follower of Sharia, and they are the follower of grace." So there are many books written in Urdu language, Shariat-e-Ilahi ya Fazl-e-Ilahi. Either we are the follower of Sharia. Sharia means the commandments. And they used to say that we are saved by grace, not by commandments. This used to be their topic. When I studied my religion, Islam, to find out what is the basis of my salvation in Islam, then I discovered that both in Christianity and in Islam, according to my humble understanding, the concept of grace and Sharia, the commandments, whatever you call it, the force behind the concept is love. The concept of salvation both in Islam and Christianity is based on love. Now, how do you explain the reality of love? How this love saved you is different in both religions. In Islam, we say that the grace is a part of Sharia. It is not something separated from Sharia. Same is in the old. Then I studied the Old Testament, from Genesis to Deuteronomy. I found out the same concept in the books, first five books. The God usually often says in books, in the book of Exodus and Deuteronomy to Moses, that teach your generation that if they follow my commandments, I will love them. So the concept of love and grace is linked with Sharia, the following of the commandments.
Yes.
When I used to meet my Christian brothers, the missionary brothers in early 80s, they used to tell me, according to the letters of Paul, that this concept that we are saved by Sharia is not a Christian concept. In Christianity, they are saved by grace of God, because no one can, be perfect enough to be saved based on their actions. Then I went back to Quran and then went back to this Sunnah of Holy Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then there is a very interesting hadith. The Hazrat Aisha, one of the beloved wife of Holy Prophet Muhammad, asked Holy Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that will we be saved based on our actions? The Holy Prophet said, no, we will not be saved based on our action. We will be saved based on the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah, because no one has perfect actions or action perfect enough to be approved, to be saved. So then in Islam and according to Quran, salvation is based on the grace of Almighty Allah, on the mercy of Almighty Allah. Same concept is there in Christianity. But then there is a theological difference between Christianity and in Islam. As according to my Christian missionary brothers who used to talk to me based on the letters of Paul, that grace, the element of grace, is something separated from Sharia. Whereas my understanding of the Old Testament, Judaism and Islam, they are one on this point, that grace is a result of following the Sharia. Sharia, grace and love of God, the mercy of God, is not something separated from the Sharia. If you follow his commandments, you will get his love and blessing. And the only thing is this, both in Islam and Christianity and in the Old Testament, God tells us in many verses that do not focus on your actions. Do not think that your action will save you. Although I have asked you to follow my commandments, but always keep in mind that the salvation is based on my mercy. It is up to me to give you the salvation. Commandments are your directions and guidelines in life, so that you can spend your life according to my will. But always keep an eye on my love and my mercy, not on your actions. The focus and the perception has been changed through the commandments of Almighty. So some people in Christianity and missionaries, they come to this theological reality in Christianity that we are saved by the grace, not by the commandment, not by the Sharia. Whereas in Old Testament and the Holy Quran, according to my understanding, grace, mercy, love, these are all the part and parcel of the Sharia of the Almighty. So this is a very theological, you know, sensitive discussion. Many books have been written on this topic. And this was the reason then I decided to decided to learn about these concepts. And when I went into the deep study of these concepts of Sharia and grace, then I found out that the force behind the both Sharia and the love and the mercy, the force behind is the love of Holy, love of God Almighty. In New Testament, it is displayed in a different sense. In the Old Testament, the love of God is displayed in a different sense. In Quran, it is displayed in a different sense. When I say the different sense, I mean it's only the vocabulary. I would say in the Quran, the Quranic vocabulary is used to display the same concept. In the Old Testament, the Old Testament vocabulary is used to display the same concept. In the New Testament vocabulary is used. So there is a difference of vocabulary, there is a difference of language. But if you go through the language, you will find the deep down, the foundation is the same. That is the love of God. So sometimes it is displayed through Sharia, sometimes it is displayed through grace, which is a hot missionary topic. That's why I selected this topic. Maybe you can.
And what is your favorite definition of love in Bible and Quran?
In the Bible, I have mentioned already, this is in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Very famous, definition of love by Apostle Paul. The first letter to Corinthians, chapter 13, the entire chapter is my favorite definition of love. And especially the verse number 13, the last one. Faith, hope, and love, these are three eternal. But the best among these three is the love. Love is the foundation of hope, and love is the foundation of faith. And if you look at from chapter verse 1 to 13 of the chapter 13, each and every word is very carefully selected. Each and every word has a deep, deep message, especially if you go through the verse number 7 of chapter 13. This is one of the best verses on handling depression and stress. These are the qualities of the love. That if you have the love in your heart, you can handle your depression, you can handle your stress. So this is my favorite quotation or favorite definition of the concept of love from the letters of Corinthians, first letter. And from the Holy Quran, Surah Al Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 31. And God Almighty says, if you love me, then you follow my prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then Allah will start loving you. He will make you his beloved. So the Quranic concept is this: if you want to learn to love God, you must learn to follow Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He will teach you how to love God. He will teach you how to become one with God in a loving and spiritual manner. So these two definitions, like this, the biblical one is in a detail description. And if you took the chapter 13 of Corinthians, 1 Corinthians, the chapter 13's entire behavioral display, you will find it in the four Gospels, the life of Jesus Christ. You will find the entire display in the book of Acts, in the lives of the apostles. Same, you will find the same display in the life of Holy Prophet Muhammad. Sometime, because that is the, theoretical understanding of the concept of love. If you take the chapter 13, entire chapter, and then apply it to the life of Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, apply it to the life of Jesus Christ, apply it to the life of Moses, you will see each and every verse is being displayed and converted into personality in these, holy prophets.
And my other question is, question that what is common between Islam and Islamic and biblical concept of love?
When it comes to the theological perspective, like God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son in the book of John, the theological aspect of the concept of love, converting it into a Christology, a Trinity, the Godship and Sonship of Jesus Christ, crucifixion, these all ideas are rejected by Holy Quran. So this is a theological difference. When you take the concept of love and convert it into a theology, into a set of rules and concepts, then these concepts which I just mentioned, Christology, Trinity, crucifixion, Sonship and Godship of Jesus Christ, these are all rejected by the different verses of Holy Quran. But when you display and exercise that love in society, in through some social manners, then it becomes equal with Islam, Christianity and Judaism. Faith in action is almost the same thing. There is no difference in that. But for example, in the Gospel of Matthew, a very famous parable of Jesus, that on the day of judgment, a man will come to see God and God will say, I was hungry, you didn't give me to eat, I was thirsty, I was sick. This parable, you see, God is deciding about his salvation based on his behavior with other people. And if you, the same concept is in Hadith of Holy Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So as a Muslim, when I'm exercising my love with my God through social behavior, the social behavior will have no title on it, whether this is a Christian behavior or Muslim behavior. You come to see me when I'm sick, or I come to see you when you are sick. When we pay respect to one another, we are getting stronger day by day in our own faith. You are becoming a better Christian, I'm becoming a better Muslim by exercising our faith. But when we are practicing our faith, there is no theology of incarnation, Trinity. This is all back in our head. What we believe in our head is not displayed through our actions. So our actions are almost, I would say, this is a part of similar part between Islam, Christianity and Judaism. When we exercise our theology at a social level, the application of theology is almost the same. There is no difference. Practical application is almost the same. When you go back to that application, to the theological part, then there is a difference. What do we mean by that? Christology and all those things. So the theology part is where we have differences, and then application part on the society level, that is the place where we have all the commonalities. Moral values are the same, ethical values are the same, social values are the same, respect for the parents, respect for the elders, don't steal, you know, don't lie, don't bribe, things like that. These are all social values which are given to us through our religion, from Christian side, from Muslim side, from Jewish side. When we practice these things, we are all on one page. We are one with one another. This is a part where we can have interfaith dialogue. But then when you go up to the theological part, the differences makes us different. Your difference makes you a Christian. My difference makes me a Muslim. Their difference makes them a Jewish. So theological differences are our identities in the society. But when we exercise that theological difference in community level, social level, our moral values, ethical values become are the universal values basically, and they are all the same in all three religions.
Right, and what I understood from your conversation and your point in that you are emphasizing on your attitude, your behavior, and your social life. What you are, you know, what's your relationship with the people, and not on just based on their religion, but based on your teaching, how much you practice and how much you care about the people, and that is more important than the theological difference and the theological, you know, barriers and all these things. And I would like to ask you that again. The question is that when we have so much similarities, we have so much like these social values, moral values given by our religion or theological background, that unfortunately, again, the situation is that in Pakistan or around the world, that we have this examples and education and the qualities and everything, but why we lack this so much love among us that we cannot live peacefully, and the world is entirely can be entirely different when we understand these kind of concept and we talk like this topic like this, so we can make this world a very beautiful place.
Yeah, I think sometimes my own personal analysis and conclusion is this: we are linked with our religion, but we don't have any personal relationship with our God.
Oh, that's great.
These are two different things. You can be a part of religious community, but still be a non-practicing Muslim or non-practicing Christian. Unless you have a personal relationship and connectivity with God Almighty, only then you can be able to understand the reality of your own faith and the reality of your existence in this world, where you see a lot of people coming from different backgrounds, from different religious backgrounds. So the personal relationship is very important. Nowadays, you will see, even in Islamic communities, being a Muslim, coming from a Muslim background, I see people are connected with rituals, routine rituals. They say five times a prayer. Okay, they perform all those religious duties, but they are not connected with God Almighty. Same as you will see a lot of Christian missionaries and pastors and business people. They are funding church, they are funding religious communities, they are funding religious organizations.
Just show that they are Christian.
Exactly. They want a religion to grow. You got my point? From the Muslim side and the Christian side, they want their religion to grow, but they don't want themselves to grow in their relationship.
In the love. That's more important. Yeah.
So once you start focusing on yourself, I think, because in Christianity and even in Kimia is Sadat Imam Ghazali, he said the best way to grow first is to start focusing on yourself. If you cannot find Islam within your own personality, you will not find it in a mosque or you will not find it anywhere else. That's why the Holy Quran says, if you want to understand God and if you want to understand yourself, start reading me. The best thing to find out about you is to connect yourself with the Holy Book. Similarly, if you want to meet Christ, Jesus Christ, if you want to understand, if you want to improve your relationship with Jesus Christ, I would say start reading the Holy Bible. Studying from the church, studying from the pastor, studying from the mosque, studying from the mullah or imam, these are a good source of education, but these are not so powerful education as far as your own direct connection with your Holy Book is concerned. You will at least understand something, and whatever you will understand, God will give more focus into that. There is a concept of the Holy Spirit in Christianity. There is a concept of Holy Spirit in Christianity, that whatever you do, if you have assistance through Holy Spirit, you will get more blessed results. Same, the concept of Holy Spirit, Ruhul Qudus, is in Surah Baqarah. Even it is said in the Holy, when you focus on Quran, Islam, the Bible, or you Holy Prophet Muhammad or Jesus Christ, when you start focusing on the foundation and start thinking about you and them, remove everyone from your mind. Remove the church, remove the mosque, remove the imam, remove the pastor. Come direct face to face with your Holy Book. I read Holy Quran, then it's like I'm meeting with Holy Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I'm talking to Allah directly. When I read Hadith of Holy Prophet Muhammad, it is like I'm talking to him. So I, through text, through revealed and blessed text, I get connected with higher authority. Sometimes I get solution of and answers of my questions which I never read in any book. This is how I get spiritually strong. I get spiritual assistance and I get spiritual connectivity by linking myself directly to the text of those holy books. Same way, if you are a Christian, start reading Bible directly. If you don't understand, pray to God. You can get some assistance from some pastor somewhere else. But once you study the Holy Bible and then practice it in the society, but this is what Jesus Christ said. For this week, my motto is to practice this commandment of Jesus Christ for 1 week. And then practice it for 1 week. And then you see, by practicing for 1 week the commandment of Jesus Christ, just one commandment of Jesus Christ or the New Testament, pick anything you like, and then practice it for 1 week, keeping in mind that this is said by Him, you will see the improvement in your spiritual connectivity. And moment by moment, every day, you will see that on, while you are practicing and trying to implement that one commandment in your life, you will get surprisingly many support from various people without asking them. So you will, this is a very different world altogether. Studying theology is one way to understand your religion, and getting yourself connected with that theology is a different thing altogether. So the best thing, I think, to become a good Christian and to become a good Muslim is to learn to connect yourself with your holy book, and through holy book to connect with God Almighty.
And you will be loved to able your neighbor ones and the people who are around you. So we can make together a better society and a better world and a better family. So Dr. Sub, thank you so much once again for your wonderful, insightful and very different talks. And again, I would like to thank everyone who are watching, and we request you all, please subscribe our channel so we can continue our work, and we will share the more in future, more different topics and different discussion. So the purpose of these discussion and talks is to build a society where we can dialogue, where we can have dialogue, we can discuss, and where we can understand each other in a better way. So we can live in a society where there is mutual respect, love, and the more the special is to understand and to make this world and be a good person. Either you are Christian, from belong to a Christian community, you become a good Christian, and from the Muslim community, to become a good Muslim. So the whole purpose and theme and aim of these talks is to together we can build a better society. So thank you very much, Dr. Sir, once again, and thank you everyone. We will see you in the future with a new topic. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Inshallah.